Then release the hands, lift the chin. And so let us begin by first aligning our breath. So we're going to begin this gentle alternate nostril breath. Bring your awareness to your left nostril. Inhale through the left. Full inhalation, but gentle. When full, switch awareness to the right nostril. Exhale, right. Emptying completely, gently. And then inhale, right. And when full, switch awareness and exhale left. So that's your pattern in and out using mental awareness. Now, if your practice involves the use of a hand mudra and you'd like to incorporate that, please feel free to do so. It is your practice, your breath, your rhythm, your pace, your practice. And then just continue that pattern. Inhaling left. Exhaling right. Inhaling right. Exhaling left. And we're going to be here for a minute or two, literally. So just stay with that pattern. Again, your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice. Alternate nostril breath. Body very still. Awareness on the breath in the nostrils. Focus at the brow point. One more minute. Maybe one more round here. Finishing up so that as you exhale on your left side, release the pattern, be very still, focus inward, notice the shifts for yourself in your experience, in your mind state, in your energetic level, in your being. Just notice what a couple minutes of breath can do to bring you present. And then let's come around to our mat and begin our movement practices. Now again, the concept here that we're bringing to mind is that gentleness is a state of mind, a state of being, and doesn't necessarily affect the vigor and effort that you place into your practice. Come down onto your back. Inhale the arms overhead. Interlock the thumbs. Press through the heels as you lengthen through the fingers. Big, long morning stretch. Good morning. Exhale. Release the toes in neutral. Switch the interlock of the thumb. Inhale. Fingers long. Press the toes away from the face. Get long. Here again. Full inhale. Exhale, bring your hands down by your Hips. Bring your knees up. Heels toward the hips, knees to the ceiling. Take the arms out 60 to 90 degrees to create a little space for your legs. Then walk your feet a little to the edges of your mat so that your knees are falling together. Now notice as you walk the feet out and the knees come together, the diaphragm will relax. Maybe put your hand on one or both hands on your belly to feel that nice lack of tension and tautness there. Keep that there. Inhale here, and then just exhale, let your legs, knees fall to one side. Just a gentle inhale back to center and let the knees fall to the other side. Again, not too far. When the hips start to rise up off the mat, that's your edge. Let's not go past there. We're not trying to force anything here. Today's exercise is how to be kind and gentle to ourselves. What does our practice look like when we introduce the concept of gentleness? So maybe that involves not trying to find an edge all the time. Maybe that involves staying in this calm, steady center. Maybe not. Find your breath and work with your breath here. A couple more. Exhaling over, inhaling up. Walk the feet in towards each other. Bring the knees into the chest. Reach up and squeeze if you like. And then a little rock side to side. Maybe release the knees and just rotate the hips one way. And then the other. Again, exploring what it's like to move gently in your practice, regardless of whatever it is the practice is asking for. And then remember that it is your practice. So modify as you need, vary as you need. Inhale here, knees over the hips, shins parallel to the mat. And then take the knees away from the face. Toes maybe just hovering over the mat. Exhale, bring the knees in. So we're beginning to line the movement with breath again. Simple movements. Just a few of these. Opening up the hip flexors a little bit. A lot of work today in the hips. We hold our stories in our hips. And I'm going to see if we can let our story flow a little bit. One more time here. Inhale away, exhale the knees in, bring the hands to the knees and squeeze, rock a little side to side. Then let's add a little movement here. So bring the hands down by the hips, palms down. If you need additional support, bring the thumbs underneath the sits bones. And for even more support, bring the back of the palms underneath the top of the buttocks, the SI joint. And then we're going to inhale, bring the right knee towards the base as the left foot extends. So creating that space, and then switch with your breath. Exhale. And right leg goes long, left knee comes in. And then just find your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice. So we're just kind of alternate, press the leg. Shoulders and back are not relaxed and against the mat. We feel that lower back against the mat, so we're not sort of arching in the lower back here. We're pressing down on the side ribs to feel the entire spine. That's our support. Our spine is supporting us here. And then just move gently, pistoning your legs, feeling the hip flexors and the core begin to engage, fire up, welcoming you to your day. Maybe it's early where you are, like it is where I am, just starting our day here. Couple more. And on your next inhale, take both legs long. And then slowly lower the feet. Let the toes fall open. Turn the palms up and take a full inhale. Just breathe into effortlessness for a moment. Let everything settle. A full inhale. A complete exhale. Turn your palms down. And again, options to bring the thumbs under the sits bones and back of the palms under the SI joint. Take the legs high. Press through the heels, straighten the legs. Now, pull down to your side root. Feel that lower spine against the mat. And then we're going to alternate here. So Take your right foot, press it to the ceiling, and then exhale, let your left leg keep it straight as it lowers toward the mat. Inhale, the left leg back up, just past the right. Press to the ceiling through the left, and then let the right leg come down. And again, find your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice, feeling into this movement for you. Gently lowering one leg at a time and raising, scissoring the legs, keeping the leg that's upright pressed through the ceiling. Try to keep it still. Feeling into this wonderful opening of the body here. Just a few more of these. Gently moving with breath. All about alignment of movement and breath. One more on each side here. Bring the knees into the chest, reach up and squeeze. Release, and then rock a little side to side. And again, your choice, maybe rotate the hips. That feels a little more releasing to you. If you rotate the hips, please go both directions. All right. And then bring the feet down by the hips. Now we're gonna begin our, come into our bridge pose. So the heels are in alignment with the hips, which means the feet are very sort of close together because your hips are not as wide as you think. And feel as if you could press into the feet. So I feel like you're pushing down into the feet, and that will begin to, you'll begin to feel perhaps that pelvic bowl begin to tilt and lift. Pressing into the feet, begin to roll up, lifting the buttocks, rolling up into the lower back, the middle back, the upper back, and maybe even the shoulders. No weight in the head or neck. You can bring the hands underneath you if that helps. You feel that lift, pinkies are down. I advise you keep the hands out by the hips so that you have room because we're gonna pulse this. So find your belly button lifting to the ceiling, press into the feet, keep the knees moving toward each other, tendency of the knees to flop open. So let's avoid that by rotating the thighs inward and keeping the knees parallel or moving toward each other. Take a full inhale here. And then as you exhale, slowly roll back down until the buttocks are just hovering over the mat. And again, inhale back up. Rolling and lifting, and then just continue this movement at your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice. So again, gentleness does not necessarily mean there's not effort or engagement. It just means that our attitude is to be gentle in our efforting. So dynamic movement here, dynamic bridge, powerful posture, gentle mind. Today's practice, gentle on your mind. What is your practice like if you introduce the concept of being gentle? Couple more here. On your next inhale, inhale, roll up, and then maintain your posture, but breathe here. So long, deep inhale while the body is lifted, complete exhales. This is our static bridge pose. We're in bridge pose, holding the moment in the bridge. Full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale here. Exhale, slowly roll down, release, and bring the knees into the chest. squeeze if you like, rotate if you like, roll side to side if you like, let everything get loose, let everything go, tell tension in that lower back and in the core. Then release the legs long and roll to your belly. Either direction doesn't matter. Gonna come into our cobra posture first. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders, thumbs at the breast line. Bring your elbows toward your hips behind you. On your inhale, press lightly into the fingertips. Press the tops of the feet. Feel the legs engage. Lift the heart. Lift the crown. Lift the head. Maybe even lift the hands. And then we're going to pulse this movement. Exhale, lower down. Pulsing cobras. Inhaling up. Exhaling in. Inhale. Your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice. One more here. On your next inhale, inhale up. Now maintain this posture while breathing. Full inhale. Complete exhale. Notice a little, maybe a little rocking action. Maybe you can neutralize that. Maybe not. Just be where you are, gently lifted into cobra. Inhale here. Exhale, lower down. Press into the fingertips. Curl the toes of the feet. Press up into a tabletop posture. Knees underneath the hips. Hands underneath, maybe slightly ahead of the shoulders. Now, inhale here. Exhale, press the hips back toward the heels and find your wisdom pose, your child's pose. Forehead drops toward the mat. Hips move toward the heels. Hands stay long, press into the fingertips. Breathe into the back. Find the wisdom in this pose. Remember, this pose always available to you at any time. Take your practice where it needs to be. Listen to the wisdom of your body. Do what is right for you. Your body will tell you what it needs. Just listen to it. If you need to be in child's pose or wisdom pose, then you move to that. Inhale, back to table. And then exhale, walk the hands out. Keep the hips high. Let the chest drop toward the mat. So coming into our heart melting pose. So bring the forehead toward the mat. Keep walking the fingertips out. Arms stay long and engaged, but shoulders release and relax. Chest moves towards the mat. Hips stay high. Breathe here. Full inhale. Complete exhale. On your next inhale, slowly walk your hands back underneath the shoulders. And then curl the toes, press back through the heels, and pick up the knees. Find this balanced, supported posture first. So you're pressing into the fingertips, lengthening out of the forearms, pressing back through the hips, knees are bent, and then just let your head drop, crown moves toward the mat, and then lift your hips toward the ceiling, and then back towards the bottom of your mat. So the hips move up and back, crown moves down, heels drop toward the bottom of your mat. This is your down dog. Take a moment here to stabilize in your down dog. Find a gentle down dog. Full inhale. And complete exhale. Bend one knee, press back through the opposite heel. Inhale here. And exhale. As you exhale, bend the opposite knee and press back through that other heel. And again, full inhale. Complete exhale. Bend both knees, lift the hips high and back, and then slowly let your heels drop. Maybe your legs come straight, maybe not. Doesn't matter. It's not about your legs. It's about opening through the back and shoulders, the forearms, the fingertips, the heel, the palm. Full inhale here. Complete exhale. Maybe look up under that left armpit. Maybe take your right hand and reach back behind your left calf. Feeling a little stretch along the right side of the body. Breathing here, full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale, bring your right hand back out. Establish yourself in your downward dog posture. Full inhale here. Maybe as you exhale, bring the left hand back behind the right heel or the right calf. Maybe looking up under your right armpit. Full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale, left hand back out. Exhale, press the hips high. Breathe deep. Inhale, out to a plank. Just establish it. Maybe you need to adjust a little bit to get your supported posture, your balance right. And then exhale, press back, downward facing dog. On the inhale, look up between the hands. On the exhale, bring the left foot forward. Help it if you need to. Step between the hands. For this first one, let's drop the right knee in the top of the right foot. Bring your left hand inside the left foot. Walk the left foot to the edge of the mat. Stay here or roll to the outside of that left foot, opening that left hip. Stay here or, if you like, walk your hands out a little bit, maybe even coming down to your elbows. Maybe not. It's early yet. Feeling into an opening in the hip, breathing and being gentle with ourselves. So maybe we find our gentle lizard posture. Breathing here, full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale here. Slowly walk the hands back underneath the shoulders if you had them out. Flatten that left foot and walk that left foot back in line with the hip. Take the left hand outside. Bring the right hand inside the left foot. Inhale, rotate the torso left. Maybe take the arm high. Simple twist. Inhale here. Exhale, bring the left hand back down. Curl the ball, the right foot, lift the right knee, step back, press back, downward facing dog. Full inhale here. Complete exhale. Inhale here, look up between the hands. Exhale, bring the right foot forward, help it if you need. And again, drop the left knee, top of the left foot. Bring the right hand inside the right foot, walk the right foot to the edge of the mat. Maybe rolling to the edge of that right foot, opening the right hip. Maybe walking the hands out. Maybe coming to the elbows, maybe not. Breathing here. Opening the right hip. Gentle lizard pose. How is our approach to our practice different if we intentionally bring gentleness to the forefront? Breathing here, full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale here. Exhale. On your next inhale, your hands are out in front, maybe walk them back. Roll to that flat of the right foot and then bring the right foot back in line with the hip. Right hand comes outside. Left hand comes inside the right foot. Rotate to the right, maybe taking the right arm high. Simple twist. Full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale here. Exhale, right hand comes back down. Left Toes curl, lift the left knee, step back, press back, down facing dog. Full inhalation. Complete exhale. On the inhale, the left leg goes straight back as if you're pressing the wall behind you. And then take the leg high. Inhale here. Exhale. Rotate, stack the hips, lift the left knee toward the ceiling, drop the left heel toward the right buttock. Gently opening into this three-legged dog with a twist. Inhale here. Exhale, rotate the hips back level. Inhale the left leg high. Exhale, bring that left foot through. Help it if you need to. Now you have the option to drop that right knee or keep the right knee lifted. Establish your support here, press into the left heel and bring your torso forward. Maybe pick up your fingertips. Press back through the right heel, lift the right thigh. Inhale here. Exhale, maybe take your hands back along your hips. Inhale. Maybe bring the arms out, biceps frame the ear. Get long. Sink the hips as you lengthen through the fingers. Breathe. Full inhale, gentle. Exhale, bring the hands down, frame the foot, step back, press back, downward facing dog. Full inhalation. Complete exhale. Inhale, the right leg straight back as if you're stamping the wall behind you. And then high. Exhale, rotate, stack the hips, lift the right knee toward the ceiling, drop the right heel toward the left butt. Breathe here. Full inhale. On your exhale, rotate the hips level. Inhale, the right leg high and up and back. Exhale, bring the right foot through. And again, option to drop the left knee or stay here. Pressing back through the heel, stabilizing, pressing down into the right heel, establishing yourself, maybe even picking up your fingers. Lengthen through the crown. Maybe take the arms back along the hips. Lean in. Inhale, maybe take the arms out. Biceps frame the ear. Full inhale. Press back through the left heel, lift the left thigh. Breathing here. In this lunge, gentle lunge. Inhale here. Exhale, hands down, frame the foot. Step back, press back, downward facing dog. A full inhale. A complete exhale. Inhale, look up between the hands. Exhale, gently walk the feet forward, bringing your feet between the hands at the top of the mat, coming into your forward fold. Release the hands, release the head. Find your balance, center and supported. Take the hands to the shins, straighten the arms, inhale to a flat back. Exhale, release the hands, release the head, forward fold. Bend the knees, feel the feet fully engaged. Inhale, begin to roll up one vertebra at a time. Gathering as you go. Torso comes upright, shoulders roll up and down, and then the arms lift. Exhale, release the hands to the heart. And take a moment to find yourself gently standing at the top of your mat in mountain pose. Find your gazing point, your drishti, remembering that balance is focus, and then feel into the weight distribution in your feet, equal and balanced, ankles soft, knees soft, firm the hips and waist, lengthen through the crown, relax the shoulders. Tuck the chin slightly, feel the full length of the spine as you breathe. Mountain pose. Standing on our own 2 feet, having our own back. Let's see if we can gently move through a sun salutation. Inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, fold, release. Inhale, rise up, gathering as you go. Exhale, release the hands. Adding on one step at a time. Inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, fold and place the hands beside the feet and step the right foot back into a lunge. Inhale here, get long into your lunge. Exhale, step the right foot forward, forward, fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, root to rise, gathering as you go through tall mountain. And exhale, hands to prayer, mountain pose. Continue moving with your breath. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale, flat back, your rhythm, your pace, your breath. Exhale, hinge and fold, hand beside the feet, left foot back into a lunge. Inhale, sink into your lunge. Find your lunge. Exhale, left foot forward, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, root to rise through tall mountain. Exhale, release the hands. I'm going to put it together now. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold hands beside the feet. Left foot back to a lunge. Right foot back to join it. Inhale to your plank, steady and sure. Exhale, gently lower down, knees, chest, chin. Come all the way to the mat. Inhale, release the tops of the feet and lift the crown. Come to cobra. Exhale, curl the toes, lift the hips, press back, down, facing dog. Full inhale and down dog. Complete exhale, find your posture. Inhale, look up between the hands. Exhale, right foot forward, left foot joins it, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, root and rise. Exhale, release the hands. Continuing on the other side, inhaling the arms up. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold hands beside the feet, right foot back, left foot joints. Inhale to your plank. Steady and sure. Exhale, lower down, your choice. Inhale, come to cobra or maybe up dog. Exhale, press back, downward facing dog. Full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale, look up between the hands. Exhale, left foot forward, right foot joins it, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, root to rise. Exhale, release the hands. Let's do one more, taking out that extra pause. So, one movement, one breath. Inhale, up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold hands beside the feet, step, hop, or jump back to plank and lower. All one big movement. Inhale, come up. Your version, cobra or up dog. Exhale, press back. Downward facing dog. Take a breath here, full inhale. Complete exhale. Inhale, look up between the hands. Exhale, walk, step, or bring your feet forward into your forward fold. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, root to rise. Exhale, release the hands. Two more of those, your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice. One movement, one breath. Be in your flow. Find your salutation. Greet the sun in your way, in your day, your practice. Stabilizing every time you come through down dog with an extra breath. Move with the breath, your rhythm, your pace, your breath, your practice. Eating up in mountain as you complete your cycle of salutations, allow everything to be still. Just focus on your experience, what it is like to be in your breath. Check in with your gratitude and your intention. Feel into this practice today. And release and come around to your seat. And we'll do a little balancing breath here before we move into our guided rest. So bring yourself to a supported seated position, whatever that means to you. Allow yourself to settle in for a moment. Then establish your seat, root down, lengthen. Bring your hands to your knees. Thumb and forefinger together, lightly touching. Palms up if you feel you need a little more inspiration. Palms down if you feel a little more need for a little more grounding. Allow yourself to settle in here. And then we're going to move into a gentle boxing of the breath. And so what we want to do is to bring your awareness to your breath. And we're going to move into a rhythmic breath where we breathe in. Now I'm going to do a 5-count breath just to get us started, but you'll find your rhythm and move with your own rhythm. But I'm going to do a 5-count inhale, inhaling 2, 3, 4, 5. And then gently retain this breath 2, 3, 4, 5. And then exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pause at the bottom and then move to it, 5 part in, or whatever your count is. Inhaling, Pausing. Exhaling. Trying to make those equal. Now turn your attention inward, be in your breath, and just continue that pattern. Your rhythm, your pace, your breath. So your count may be 2, your count may be 20. It doesn't matter. It's your practice. Equalizing the inhale. Little light retention with gentleness. No efforting here. Gentle. What is it like to breathe gently? But we're bringing our awareness to that breath. Patterning that breath in a way that allows us to be focused on our experience. Our attention on the breath. And we're just going to be here for a moment or three, allowing this pattern interrupt to do its work. Letting everything settle, bringing all of that energy that was aroused during our movement practice and allowing it to settle in. Letting the opening of the body that came from our movement, allowing what has arisen from that opening to now be integrated into the fullness of our being, just being here in our breath, your rhythm, your pace. Your breath. Your practice. And remembering our conception is to be gentle. What is our practice like if we bring the mindset and intention of being gentle into it? Staying in your pattern, about one more minute. Let your next repetition be your final repetition so that when you finish your exhale, you just let the pattern go. Be very still for a moment. Just let everything settle. And take a moment to bring yourselves down onto your backs. On your mat. And as you move onto your mat for guided rest, maybe take a moment to find any additional supports that you may want in your guided rest. Maybe you have an eye cloth, a blanket, a shawl, a bolster, anything that will provide you maybe just 1% more support, excuse me, in your rest posture. And having established yourself on your mat on your back, let your toes fall open. Take your heels as wide as is comfortable for you on your mat. Bring your palms down by your sides, palms up. Lengthen through your crown. And then imagine you can pull down on your side ribs so that you feel your lower spine fully engaged on the mat. And then just let go. Just let go. Be done. You're done. Allow yourself to be done. Release. Release any patterning of the body or breath, any shaping of the body and breath. Release any analysis of the practice, any conversations with yourself, any planning for the future, any remembrance of the past. Just be here. Just allow yourself to receive. Check in with your gratitude that you anchored at your heart space. See if it's still there. Open to that gratitude. Be grateful for this moment, this opportunity to just be. Let everything just be for a moment. Allow yourself this moment of freedom, of rest. Releasing and relaxing. Noticing if you have any areas of tension or tightness. And maybe actively bringing the breath to those areas. Perhaps softening around those areas. Or even just noticing without any need to do anything but notice. Just notice, observe. There's tension there. Tightness, contraction. No need to do anything. Returning to the idea of being gentle. What is it like to just gently rest fully and completely? Gently resting in your space. invite you once again to bring your awareness to your heart space and check in with your gratitude anchored there. And expand, if you can, your awareness so that you imagine you're witnessing yourself. Imagine you were seated, if you will, at the crown of your head and witness your entire being in your space, resting there in gratitude. See yourself, see your environment. And as you observe yourself resting in gratitude in your space, I'll take this opportunity to extend my sense of gratitude to you. Thank you so much for coming and sharing your practice with me. I'm honored to be here, truly. And as always, I invite and encourage you to stay here in grateful rest for as long as you like. And when you do rise, please take your gratitude and the echoes of your practice with you as you go about the rest of your day, lifting yourself and all that you come into contact with. Have an amazing day.